down from the Middle East. You are not native African.
No, not at all.
Ethiopian.
As a matter of fact, you don't have the Negro blood at all. And we migrated from the Semitic type of the Saudi Arabia and Yemen and the countries just away from the Red Sea. And the origin could be said that some people drafted and came to the northern part of Ethiopia. And then they migrated inwards. And time went on, they stayed and stayed. And then the Hamitic races from the bordering, from the south and from Sudan and things like that, from the countries
but
in
if you,
Africa.
Excuse me for interrupting, but if you don't have Negro blood, then this is news to me. The Ethiopians, I would think, wouldn't have any particular feeling about race relations in other parts of Africa.
We don't at all do. We don't at all feel any relationship. It's none of our concern. I mean, we just don't care about it, as we don't have the Negro blood. We shouldn't have to worry ourselves. I mean, the color you might, the color of my face, is just dark because it's due to the exposure of the sun. And my country is a mountainous country. It's 800 feet above sea level. And it's more or less nearer to the sun than is the other countries that lay near the equator.
Yuma?
Yeah.
You're not white?
And not black?
Not black. What are you?
It's just in between.
Yuma, and I would like to know, are you, for instance, very much interested in the South African race policy? Or do you stand more or less objective towards that?
Not at all. We wish you would do things fairly. I mean, we wish you don't treat the native South Africans as you do right now. But as a matter of fact, we don't care. We just listen to your policies and things that go on in South Africa. But I'd like to ask you one question. Would you think it would be would the matter be worse or better, I mean, within these few years, or what is the stand right now of this South African problem?
Could I just ask you another question before I answer yours?
Yeah.
Is there any discrimination, for instance, between the separate tribes in your country? How do you, for instance...
I'm very happy you brought that point. As a matter of fact, the Amhara tribes consider ourselves superior to the other tribes, to the adjacent tribes that live in the same community. And we just consider them inferior and consider ourselves superior. And that could be something of segregation, but it's not actually in the sense that you take it and the Americans in Little Rock take it. I mean, it's just very unprominent.
I mean, do you... I'm sorry. Do you mean that... you think that the other tribes are perhaps a little too primitive, for instance?
Not a matter of primitiveness or so. It's just a matter of ignorance, I shall say.
Oh.
I mean, the Amhara tribes are more cute and clever. And that's why, you know, they are just...
That's your tribe?
Yeah, that's my tribe. I'm
that's
proud of
very
it.
Modest, yes.
Yeah.
And Yuma, do you have whites in Ethiopia?
White people? Foreigners?
White people, yes.
Yeah, lots of them. We have the Americans, as a matter of fact. They're working in different departments. And I'd like to say one point on that. They seem to be more cooperative in... they looked as though they are cooperative in my country. And I thought it was because they were in a foreign country that they should cooperate. But no, it's... I proved it right here. They come in... They have assemblies in communities and things like that. I mean, they are more cooperative than I actually saw it in my country.
Yuma, just to get back to another point, do you then think, for instance, it's fair that if there is discrimination in Ethiopia, even between, well, the same race and the same nation...
Not the same race, of course the same nation.
The same nation.
Mm-hmm.
But do you think then it's fair to judge South Africans as white towards black? If you don't, for instance, acknowledge the less good Ethiopians,
We do acknowledge them. I don't mean we don't actually consider our discrimination, what you call it, is not as prominent and worldwide known. as seen South Africa. That's it.
Well, what are we actually saying here? That there is all kinds of discrimination, and discrimination is all right as long as it isn't too prominent, or as long as it isn't between black and white. What are we saying here anyway?
No, it's like this. She said, do you think the discrimination in your country is good, or the segregation...
Excuse me, let's hear from Susie on this, because Brazil's got a special point of view, I'm sure.
No, what they wanted to say is that he was telling her that she has discrimination. She's telling him
segregation,
he has...
Segregation, not discrimination.
I'm sorry, segregation. And she's telling him that he has a kind of segregation too. And he won't admit it.
I just told you first of all. How did you happen to know it?
You consider your segregation different.
Yeah.
Yes, because you're all different.
Well, what's it like in Brazil, Susie?
Well, my country has a very good point, a point of advantage in that, because we have no segregation at all. And we could be in the same position as the United States, because we had slaves just the same as they did, just about the same time as they did. Only our country was a colony of Portugal, the United States was a colony of England. The Englands are Anglo-Saxons, the Portuguese are Latins. And the Latin race, how to say, mingles very easily. So there were marriages between black and white, they form mulattoes, which are not black and are not white, and mingle and mingle and mingle. So now we don't have black and white. We have all sorts of colors, from white to very black, with light brown in between. And in Brazil, there's just no question that person has a little Negro blood, like here in the States. He has 1/8 of Negro blood, he's considered a Negro. He has 1/16, he's considered white. We just don't have it. You look at the person, look at another one, and they're people. That's what's different. And I wanted to ask you something, Rina. You say there's a great segregation in your country.
That's right.
And in your country, do you have prejudices against the black people?
Well, I wouldn't actually say prejudices. Perhaps I should just explain this to you. Everybody seems to have heard of apartheid during the last few months, years. And I think it's perhaps misinterpreted in most instances. I'll tell you what apartheid actually means. It means the development of two separate racial groups within their own areas. And Susie, you just now, you said that there is no discrimination whatsoever in Brazil. Could you just tell me more or less, are there more whites or more blacks in Brazil?
There are more whites.
There are more whites?
Yes, there are more whites. But you can say white and black. White and not white.
Oh, yes.
Because the blacks aren't just black. They're all colors, as I told you. Because the whites marry very easily with the black and with the Indians. In Brazil, that happens very much. So they're just, we just don't count blacks and whites. Just people, you know.
For instance,
it's very different from your country.
For instance, would you marry
a black one?
I think that I personally wouldn't marry a black one, because my parents wouldn't approve of it.
And you, don't you think that's a little bit of discrimination?
It is.
I'm sure,
my part, I wouldn't. But the real, I'm not a real Brazilian because my parents are Swiss. But the real Brazilian,
they would.
Yes, they would. And they do. They do very often. They do it all the time, in fact. Yes, there is really no discrimination in this. But now, let me come back to the question. You said you have a kind of prejudice in your country. Do you have it here? Do you feel any prejudice against a black person here? Do you feel kind of awkward?
Oh, no, not in the least. For instance, I think that integration in America is perfectly right. And I think it should be done. And therefore, I approve of it. But I just don't see how integration would work in South Africa, at least not for the present. For in South Africa, it's 3 million whites against 12 million, whilst in America, it's altogether different. And I'm quite assured that the present policy that we follow is going to be the solution of the problem at last. Actually, I hope so.
Could you imagine the Brazilian problem having been solved like that?
No, it,
why not?
It won't ever work. Because people are people. They can't be separated. You stay here, you stay here. You are white, you are black. You can't. Are you God to judge what they have to do, where they have to stay? You have to go in those schools, they have to go in those schools. You marry with this one, she marries that one. No.
No, it's not a question of who is God and who's going to judge. But it's a civilization against a civilization. After all, it is it is the white South Africans that have built up South Africa to where it is now.
With the help of whom?
With the help of the other, but with the supervision.
Who did the heavy work?
With the supervision.
Of the
perhaps it's like that, you know.
Oh, yes, perhaps it should. But I don't know. After all, it's not fair to think that South Africans should just quit all their good work right here. For instance, I couldn't tell what is going to happen in future, but I think for the present time, there is no other solution. For what would you think?
Well, I think that people have a right to live as they want to. I think you can't put a barrier between people. Let them go and do as they wish to. If they want to go to your schools, let them. If they don't want to, okay.
I'm sorry, our time's up, and you're just beginning to get into the interesting part of the discussion. It's a good note to end on that you gave us, Susie. People are people. In a brief summary, I think I've learned a couple of things tonight. I've learned a little bit more about Ethiopians' racial background. I've learned something about schools in Europe these days and the fact that they don't teach current history. We may do a little more talking about schools. I think I should say, too, that our purpose is not so much to tackle a single subject exhaustively and reach conclusions. Maybe at the end of 3 months, we'll just have a few tentative conclusions of the world we want. Our purpose is rather to give you some of the fun and maybe a little of the excitement that comes when this group of young people from all over the world get together and try to get to know each other. Our time's up, and so we have to say goodbye until this same time.